of Vienna, right? Treaty of Vienna, what we have studied, that the conservatives, they have defeated Napoleon, like Prussia, Russia, Austria, Hungary. These countries defeated Napoleon, right? And after that, they had made a treaty to distribute the territories which Napoleon had annexed. So, according to the treaty, we had discussed how they have distributed. Many states were created in the northern part of France to stop further territorial expansion. And Prussia was given a part of Saxony. Like that, we have studied. So, today, after the Treaty of Vienna, we have again discussed about the underground revolutions or the secret revolutions by Giuseppe Mazzini, like Young Europe and Young Italy, right? Then, today we have to study about a new topic, that is the Age of Revolution in 1830 to 1848. So, from 1830 to 1848, there were many revolutions took place in various parts of Europe. Every these revolutions were to create, it was carried by liberalists. So many liberalists, after the Treaty of Vienna, you have seen how the conservatives came into power in France, okay? And the territories were under, those who were under the Napoleon, they were annexed, they were distributed it away, and which were brought under the conservative regime. So conservative here in this means what? Conservative means the old regime or the old monarchy, monarch or tradition they followed. They were known as conservatives. Liberalist means they wanted democratic republic or national assembly, parliament, election. These all people were modern in their outlook. And these liberalists were mainly professionals, educational people, teachers, lawyers, professionals, people, etc. So, liberalism, they undertook many revolutions in various parts of Europe from 1830 to 1848. One of the revolutions took place after this conservative, we have learned, you remember that Treaty of Vienna happened after that conservative followed their Bourbon dynasty in France, but 1830 after that in France, they had made a revolution, liberalist followed a revolution. In that revolution, the liberalist made the revolution and they had made a constitutional monarchy. Constitutional monarchy means monarch or emperor had to follow the constitution made by the liberalist. So that they had made, and Louis Philippe, he was made as the constitutional monarch in France in 1830. So after the first upheaval or the first revolution of liberalism, which started in 1830 in France. So Louis Philippe was made as the constitutional monarch, and they had made this liberalist form of, or their constitution they had developed, and they had made Louis Philippe as the head. But you can see that Metternich, he had hosted the Treaty of Vienna, Duke Metternich. Right? He was the Chancellor of Austria, and he had hosted the Treaty of Vienna, or the when the Vienna Congress they met, it was hosted by Duke Metternich. So Duke Metternich, he had quoted that, or he had made a very interesting quotation, that when France sneezes, the rest of the Europe catches cold. Means when France sneezes, in the sense every changes which brings from France. You have learned about French Revolution. Same way, every revolution or changes which first occur in France. So here also, the liberalist revolution in 1830 first took place in France. So that he had quoted that when France sneezes, the rest of the Europe catches cold. So when in France, liberalist made a revolution, that is by other European countries or neighboring countries of Europe, they also got the same type of liberalist revolution they quoted. So same thing which happened, that rest of the Europe catches cold. This was one of the interesting quotation that who quoted? Duke Metternich. So in exam, this sentence sometimes is asked, who stated this sentence? Or it can be asked why it was stated. So you have to understand the situation where it was in 1830 to 1848 revolutions. This took place. Belgium was broken away from Netherlands and UK. This was happened in Belgium, nearby country of France. Next thing that same one type of another revolution. So I have told you that when France started this type of revolutions, it spread to many other parts of the Europe. So we have discussed one another country, that is Belgium. Next it spread to Greece as an important country. Greece was very important European country because it had a very ancient civilization, Greek culture, Greek civilization. So that cradle of civilization which flourished in Greece, that is why. And Greece was for a long time under the Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire means Turkey, Ottoman Turkey Empire. They were also capturing or they were expanding the territories nearby areas, and Greece was under the Ottoman Empire. So for a long time Greece was suffering the same problem that ruling by somebody. So Greek people wanted to make some movement. Like you have seen in France, same way, when the France Revolution or the 1830 revolutions in France spread to liberal revolution spread to other countries, it reached in Greece. In Greece, Greek people wanted to get independence from Ottoman Empire. So that they had started the revolt. Many changes happened in their society. When this revolution or some uprising started in Greece, many people helped the Greek people. Or Greece got a lot of help from various parts of the Europe. Not because many Europeans had sympathy to the Greek culture. Because Greek culture was very much flourished and fertile. It was. In the case of architecture, literature, poem, many such things, Greek people had contributed well before. So that Greek culture made many Europeans sympathetic outlook towards the Greek nationalism. And many Europeans, they had contributed by fund or by money or by attending themselves in war. So many such people contributed, and Greek got a lot of help from various people. Same way, one of the English poet, he was an English poet, he was known as Lord Byron. So Lord Byron, he was an English poet, he helped Greece for getting the national movement. So when he collected fund, so what Lord Byron did, he had, was an English poet, he had collected the fund or money, and he had contributed for the Greek war. Okay, Greek nationalist movement. And he himself attended the war. He himself went to the war or the uprising, and there, but unfortunately, he died in the war by attending the war, not by attending the war itself, but by fever. That is one of the important for me that happened to Lord Byron. We may think that Lord Byron was attending the war, so he had killed in the war. Not like that. He had died due to fever. And this happened in Greek. So it was during the period that is started in the period 1821, Greek revolution started. Lord Byron, he had helped by collecting the fund, and he himself attended the war, but he had died due to fever. Okay? And at last, in the year 1832, a treaty was made. So 1832 treaty was made, that was known as the Treaty of Constantinople. Greek became an independent nation from the Ottoman Empire. So Ottoman Empire was capturing Greece for a long time. And Greece got independence, or Greece became a nation after 1832 with the treaty known as Treaty of Constantinople in 1832. So that Treaty of Constantinople in 1832 you have to understand very well, because it is also one of the important questions which is mostly asked in the examination. Okay? So this is one of the important things happened in Greece. So we were learning that 1830 to 1848, what were the incidents happened? Clear? Liberalist movement happened, liberalist revolutions happened. First it took place in 1830 in France. So due to that France revolution, Duke Metternich, he had said that when France seizes rest of the Europe captures gold. After that, the neighboring country that is Belgium, where the liberalist movement took place, and Belgium, it started in Brussels. Okay, Brussels as the capital city you have studied in the civics lesson. So Belgium was separated from the Netherlands and UK after due to this revolution. Same thing happened to Greece. Greece story you understood very well. The independence, Greek War of Independence. So sometimes this is asked for. Explain the Greek War of Independence is one of the important questions which is asked most probably in the board exam. And also 1832, the Treaty of Constantinople was made. Okay. Next thing we have to study. You have learned that these all war happened not because of the only because of the revolutions. Many things, many factors contributed to the this type of revolutions. Not only the revolt, not only the wars and this happened. Okay, aggressiveness and the national unification, the liberalist mind to a liberalist want or desire to get the national unification. This national unification was not only by war and conflicts, but also many such things affected or many such things contributed in this national unification. Another important thing that which contributed to the national unification in every other parts of Europe was Romanticism. Romanticism in the sense what? Romanticism means the culture, poetry, their literature, language, everything contributed for the national unification. This process is known as Romanticism. So Romanticism means the cultural movement or the cultural movement sought to develop, the nationalist sentiments in Europe is known as Romanticism. Means the cultural movement which sought to develop the national unification or nationalist movement is known as what is that? Romanticism. Okay. Now we have to study Romanticism. Many things we have to study. In that first, so I have told you that, is it clear to you? Because Romanticism means it is a cultural movement which contributed for the national unification. And it is not by the war alone. So many cultural movement, culture in the sense what are the way of living, right? So in that our way of living, we have developed many things. Okay, writing, poetry, literature, language, everything is there. So these all factors contributed for the national unification. Such factors we have to discuss now. So Romanticism, in that we have to discuss the factors which were included in the Romanticism. In the first important thing that the poem, language, then literature, everything affected for the national unification of various parts of Europe. First thing that one of the important German philosopher, he was known as Johann Gottfried Herder. He was a French philosopher and he had a very attachment towards the German culture. He understood that German culture is very nourishing. So that he had such attachment towards the German culture. He had created the common people, or he had emphasized the common people, Das Volk. Das Volk, that means he emphasized about the Das Volk, common people, their ancient, their German culture. He had, or he was a philosopher, he had even emphasized more importance to the culture, and he emphasized the German culture. So he emphasized on the Das Volk. That was one of the important things which affected the national unification in Germany or in Europe, various parts of Europe. So Romanticism, in that we are learning what are the important things which come in the Romanticism. First important Romanticism, one of the important philosopher, he was German. He had a lot of importance for the German culture. He had emphasized on Das Volk, means common people, okay? Common people's reactions, common people mentality, these all he had even emphasized. And another important thing that many people had emphasized from the vernacular literature. Vernacular means their local literature, local dialects, that was even more important. Another, many people, they had given a lot of emphasis on music. Such type of music, giving more importance to music, was Karol Kurupinski. He was a Polish, he was a poet, he had given more importance for music as a for the national unification. Okay? that Karol Kurpinski, he had celebrated operas, music, and also folk dance, etc. Folk dance, for example, Poland's folk dance were known as Polonaise and Mazurka. These dances like Polonaise and the Mazurka, these were emphasized. More importance was given for that so that people got inspired. This is our ancient culture. This is our importance of our culture. So we need to be united for the nation. Like that, the people got a sentiment towards the culture. So this type of culture through music, it was developed by Karol Kurpinski from Poland. He had emphasized from the music, opera, festival, many festivals, and he had celebrated these all things, and also folk dances like Polonaise and Mazurka. These all made the sentiments or enriched the sentiments of the Europeans. Okay, in various parts of Europe, for example, I told you that Poland, Karol Kurpinski, German, John Gottfried, Herder, like the many people, they enrich the sentiments. These all sentiments, enrichment or increasing the sentiments, these all came to be known as romanticism. So it was a cultural moment. Okay? And another thing, that language also had a lot of importance in this romanticism. People wanted to speak their own mother tongue. Okay? And we know that Poland was under Russian custody or Russian dominance. So Russian people had made or they had enforced Russian language in Poland. Polish people cannot speak their own language, Polish language. So that some priests, bishops, etc., what they did, they started speaking in Polish in their church mass gathering. In their mass or church gathering, they, when the prayer starts, they started preaching the religion in their language, Polish language.